Hi, this is Chuck Carnevale. Welcome to the 2-Minute Drill. How do you evaluate a cyclical stock using the FastGraphs Fundamental Analyzer Research Tool? This video was inspired by a subscriber that asked about Arch Coal, and he thought it has a company that had real good fundamentals and the price was down, and he really wanted me to kind of go through how I would evaluate the company. So I want to start by separating the business from the stock. And you know what I mean by that, the stock market will price a business according to a lot of things. Emotions often get involved. But what we're looking at here is simply a plotting of earnings only on Arch Coal from the period 2002 out to 2012. And what you see here is the company was very cyclical. Notice there were no earnings in these first 2 years. So we had an average earnings growth rate of 8.6%. Now let me drop off those 2 years and just to kind of focus more on this last 9 years. You can see the earnings have gone up, down, up, down. You know, it's got a lot of cyclicality into the company's operating history. Now, when I look and bring stock prices into the equation, I find something very interesting here. I see that the stock price was way ahead. This orange line is what we call the orange earnings justified valuation line. And here that looks like the stock price is significantly ahead of earnings. And then there was this drop in earnings here, which precipitated a huge drop in the stock price. So we're going to analyze that a little deeper as we go through the video. But first, I want to bring in this notion of a normal PE ratio. This is simply a calculation that the computer, you know, tries to determine what's normal for this company over whatever time frame measuring. Here we're measuring a 9-year time frame, which is 8 years of history in the year we're in. And so if you just simply understand that this blue line represents 36.6 times earnings on this graph, so here it's 36 times earnings, here it's 36 times earnings, etc., you can see that here was a period where the price was below 36 times earnings, but above the 15 multiple that the orange line represents. Here it was above 36 times earnings, and now it's well below that, currently trading at 9.9 times earnings. But let's look a little deeper at what's really going on here. So, you know, I go back, I calculate, and I recognize that this company has an 8.6% earnings growth rate. And as I shorten the time frame here to only a 6-year chart, I find out that there is no growth rate. Now, this is interesting, and it shows what happens to a cyclical company because, you know, earnings growth was good up through here, and then we had this collapse of earnings from $2.37 down to 31 cents, an 87% drop in earnings, and the stock price fell precipitously. But let's continue to dig a little deeper into what's really going on here. What I've done here is I've gone and actually picked a period in history. I'm looking at 2004 to 2008 because this is a time when the company actually strung together some really powerful earnings. The earnings growth rate was 49.5% because it went from 47 cents up to $2.37. And you can see we had a 614% growth rate and a 94% growth rate. So the stock price followed that, but then we had this, you know, this massive drop in stock price that you see here, because what happens, since it's such a cyclical company, when the earnings finally collapse from the $2.37 to the 37 cents, you can see, and you know, and by 2009, you can see that the stock price reacted to that, you know, very, very dramatically, or in a very dramatic fashion. Now let's go back to real time. You know, we're looking at the period, the 15-year period, 1998 to 2012, and kind of analyze what we looked at here a few moments ago. You know, what we saw was a period of weak earnings here, and stock price was kind of flat. Then we had that period I showed where we had almost 50% earnings growth, and the stock price had actually reacted very strongly to that. Then once the earnings disappeared again, the value of the stock price disappeared, and then it got high again, and now we see the stock price, you know, pretty much on the orange line. And so what I want to do is I want to focus on the future from this point forward. What you're looking at here is the consensus of 21 analysts reporting to First Call, and the analysts do expect a drop in earnings in calendar year 2012, and which is also their fiscal year, and then they're expecting earnings to grow at about 18% a year. There are some issues with, you know, some regulations the Department of Energy is planning on coal and stuff that's got the entire coal industry actually in a downdraft here. But what's important is the company, I believe, is trading at a fair valuation for the first time in a long time. It's trading at less than 10 times earnings. You know, I don't know, you know, remember the cyclical nature of this company, so how much we can rely on this earnings growth here. But I would say this is a fairly priced company here, but I want to remind the viewer that, you know, this is really a very cyclical company, and it's really hard to know what it looks like going forward. But this all makes sense to me today in that Arch Coal was being priced because of a down year in earnings, and you can pick it up at an attractive valuation. If it gets any earnings growth, it's probably a good buy here.